React Router just dropped this new hook that's gonna blow your mind, and today I wanna show it to you. I have this React Router project, and the hook itself is available from version 7.9, so that's the minimum requirement to use it, and let me show you how you can do that. So imagine the following scenario. You have some product ID, and that route returns a loader. And that loader looks something like this. So you export something, you return a product. That product has an ID, it has a title, it has a description, and so on and so forth. And now you want to render that on the client. So what you're going to do is you're going to return that via loader data. And then you have some sort of component and you pass it into the component to render it. So now the component has something like this. So it has a product, it takes the ID, title, description, and price. And now right off the bat, you might be seeing the issue. And that issue is if you're using this product card with this hard-coded type, if I go back to the route and then I change anything inside of here. So for example, I move the description, the component is gonna complain. So the first thing we could do to fix that is we could go into the product card. Or rather, we could do something like this. So export type product loader data, and that's going to be return type of loader. And if I hover over this, that's going to be the product. So now I want to use this to type the card. So now instead of doing this, I can just type this whole type as product loader data and import it from the route. And that works now. So for example, if I go back to the product route and if I change anything in the loader, so for example, if I add I don't know, image URL, and that points to some slash image. That's really cool, and that works. And if I go inside of here, if I do product dot, yeah, I get the image URL. So that's really cool. But what if this component itself was really nested inside of the JSX? So for example, it was five levels deep instead of one. Well, I would like to use a hook to access it. And there are a few ways. So for example, you could do data is equal to use loader data. But then first of all, it has to be on that specific route. And second of all, it's not type safe. So for example, if I hover over this, it's gonna say that the data is any. So that's absolutely not what we want. So we want this to be type safe. Another way you can do it is with use route loader data. Now this would allow you to get the loader data, but you would still have to typecast it here, and then this can be like any string here, so we have no idea if this is actually the correct way of accessing this data or not. So that's another issue. Well, this is where the new hook comes in. The new hook is called unstable use route, and now I know that it's prefix with unstable, but it's pretty stable. It's just brand new, so they don't want to say it's stable yet. And what we're going to do is we're going to do data is equal to this hook, and we're going to do the following. We're going to open this up, and as you can see, we actually get the actual route IDs that are supposed to be passed into use route loader data. And as you can see, we had a bug where we didn't prefix it with routes. So this old approach would throw this and you would get basically nothing. Now check this out. If I do const product is equal to data dot something, we actually get action data and loader data from the product route. And why is this really cool? Well, if I do data loader data dot product, what I get if I hover over this and if I actually delete this and this as well, I actually get the product. And as you can see, it's either this or undefined, because the loader data can be undefined if we use this hook, because maybe we're not rendering it in a page that's using this loader data. So a simple guard that if the product is not there, we return product not found. And indeed, if I run the dev server and then I open up the actual route that contains this, you can see that we actually get the product info from the loader data. And what this means is if we go back to the code, this doesn't use the loader data as a prop anymore. We don't have to pass in the types anymore. And we can actually go to our product page. We remove this as well, and we save this. And the cool thing about this, you can also remove this part, and you don't have to export this anymore. So as you can see, we're just deleting a bunch of code. And the cool thing is, for example, if I delete the title, the product card is going to complain because the title is not there anymore. And this is the awesome thing about this new hook, is that it's type safe. And as soon as you change the loader, the underlying types change. So this means you get full type safety, whatever you're doing. And you don't really have to worry about changing like 7 places that uses this loader data or forgetting to update one of them and then your app crashes. And this is an amazing way to actually retrieve data from your loaders inside of components that are not close to the route module. And that's pretty much it out of this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.